Vibrato is a really easy skill to learn the technique of. What's more difficult is to apply vibrato in the right way, depending on what style you're using. If you're playing, say, mariachi music, the vibrato is very fast and short. If you're playing something else, it might be longer. So I'm going to give you three different ways to do the vibrato, and my opinion on each of those ways. So the first way, this is the way that I learned, and this is using my fingers. What I'll be doing is just very gently rocking my fingers back and forth on the valves. And depending on how fast I do that, that will affect the speed of the vibrato. So basically what's happening is that's moving the horn on and off my chops. And there are some reasons that that's not a very good way to do it. It's the way that I learned. It's the way that I do naturally after lots of practice. And so I kind of just stick with it. Here's an example. Okay. Another way, and this is the way I've been trying to get myself to begin doing vibrato, is to use the jaw vibrato. And in doing that, I'm just doing that with my jaw. And same thing, you can vary the speed. If you do it quickly, you'll get a fast vibrato. If you do it more slowly, you'll get a slower vibrato. And this is what it sounds like. Okay, probably couldn't see that very well. It's a very slight motion, but that's how you do that. And the final way is the breath vibrato. This is the way that singers, flutists, sometimes other wind players use this. It's more difficult to do. Some people think you have more control. It also doesn't involve anything messing with your embouchure, so that's a good way. I play flute a little bit, so I've been messing around with that, with flute. And here's a version on trumpet. I don't usually do it this way, so we'll see how it comes out. A little hand vibrato on the end just out of habit. So you also notice that my vibrato changes speed over the course of the note. Depending on the style, again, it may start out slow and go quickly and then go slow again. It just depends on what you think sounds good and what the style calls for. So the best thing for vibrato, because it's such an easy skill to use, the best thing for your vibrato is to just really listen for it in music that you like, and you'll probably hear it, whether it's vocal music or saxophone or trumpet or anything else. Vibrato is usually in there. It helps to make the tone richer, warmer, more interesting. It also helps a little with intonation. If you're a little bit out of tune, that vibrato will kind of mask that. So it's another great reason to use it. So mess around with that, have fun, and good luck.